Hello, my name is Pawan Kumar, and in this video, we are going to learn how we can deploy project or Kubernetes cluster object with the help of Argo CD tool. In my last video, I have shown you that how you can create and implement Argo CD server on Kubernetes cluster. And then we have also seen that how we can access Argo CD as a web page. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a project with the help of Argo CD tool. To start this demo, you will need a YAML file where you have written a code that how you can deploy pod, service, and other objects for running an application. If you don't have code, I'm going to show you that you can use my code and you can practice by deploying your project on Argo CD. So right now you can go to my GitHub page and you can select a repository which is called GKE project. And here you can use this repository to practice that how you can deploy Argo CD, how you can deploy application with the help of Argo CD. So you're going to use this repository. So I'm going to copy the repository ID, URL ID, and then I'm going to the settings and click on repository and click on connect repo using HTTPS and paste the repository ID at here and connect. Once you can see the status connection status is successful, you can now come back to manage your application tab and then you can click on new app. When you will click on new app, it will ask you the name of your application. You can add any name of your application. I'm just going to add first demo on Argo CD. So any name that you can identify your application, you can name it. Okay. The project will be default. In the next video, I'm going to show you that how you can create other projects. But right now I'm going to use a default project at here. It is asking that what is the source of your code that you have put your YAML code. So I'm going to add the repository which I have added earlier. Then I'm going to add the path. As you can see that my all YAML files are in a root directory of repository. So I don't have to specify any name. I will just add dot. Dot means it is going to pick all the YAML file from my root folder of my repository. So I added dot and now I need to add the destination where this YAML code is going to deploy. So I'm going to add the internal Kubernetes cluster. But if you have not deployed Argo CD on a same Kubernetes cluster, so you need to add Kubernetes cluster at here. So you can go to this settings and you can click on cluster and then you can add, if you have any other cluster in your infrastructure, you can add that cluster at here. But right now I'm going to use the internal cluster. So let's do a process again. First demo on Argo CD. Project will be default and the source is the git repository that I have added. Path will be the dot and the cluster will be the internal cluster and the namespace where you want to deploy. So right now you can see that in my YAML format I have added a namespace project one. So you would need to create project one. If you have not added any namespace into your YAML file, so you don't need to specify or you don't need to create any namespace. So right now I'm going to add project one. And before this, you need to go on Cloud Shell and you need to add namespace, kubectl create ns and project one. So this command you have to run to create namespace on your Kubernetes cluster. And then we are okay now. So we can just click on create. Okay, so I can see that it is asking, okay, so the name format which I have provided, which is not acceptable. So I need to add something which is acceptable, the name. The demo, first demo, and then create. Okay, so we are done now. So you can see the status is missing. Why it is saying missing? Because I have not synchronized this application right now, and it is out of sync, right? So when we click on this, it will show you the architecture that how it is going to deploy, but it is not into deployment. So what you need to deploy it, you just click on sync, and you need to apply online and then synchronize. So once you will do this, it will start deploying your application YAML onto the Kubernetes cluster, and on behalf of you, it will create the PVC that you have added. That you can see that I have added the storage right here. So in the storage, I have added PVC. So whatever object you have declared into the YAML file, so it is going to deploy on your cluster. So you can click on refresh so that you can see the latest status right here. So you can see that I have the PVC is created, the SSD volume is created, the HTTPD port has been created. Now it is in progress, HTTPD service. So you can click. So if you want to see the status of it, you can click on it and it will give you the complete detail of it here. If you will see any issue, you can click on events. There is no events right now. So if any problem will occur, you can simply click on events and it will give you the brief introduction, brief detail of the problem that you are facing right now. So if you have any issue in your code, it will also give you the detail that what is the issue in your code so you can fix it. So now you have taken your YAML into the GUI format, and now you can see that I have deployed my application. So what I need to do is basically I need to refresh at here on cluster service, and then I will check. Okay, so this is my HTTPD service which I have created right now, and I'll click on it and then refresh. So you can see my website is deployed now. So you can see that you can deploy your project or your application objects on Kubernetes cluster with the help of Argo CD tools. Now you can see it here. So simply what you need to do is basically you can simply change the YAML and you can commit it at here, and it will definitely, it is going to sync at here. But right now we have set up the it's not automated sync right now, it's manual sync right now I have set. So you need to do is a automated setup, automated sync. So once you will do this, it will automatically go and check the code, any commit will happen on the Kubernetes cluster or on GitHub. In GitHub YAML, any changes will occur, it will Argo CD will detect and it will deploy or update your project. So that's it in this video. I will add one more video on this. So I'll show you right now. You have seen that how you can add the declarative YAML format file to deploy your projects. You can also use other tools like Helm to deploy your projects. So if you have a code in Helm, so you can also use Helm at here. So I will show you that project as well in my next video. Meanwhile, take care, enjoy, and bye bye.